Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14 Developer Beta 3. This is available to all iOS 14 supported devices. If you're a developer, you can download and install it now. And if you aren't seeing it already, the public beta should be out either later today or tomorrow based on what Apple's done in the past. You can see this came in at 696.7 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it was about 500 or 600 megabytes on the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. As well as the iPhone SE, the original iPhone SE. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. You can see the build number is 18A5332F, and this particular build adds a couple different changes to things such as the music icon we'll talk about in a moment, and there is a new modem update, so it's nice to see them continually work on that, and they did fix that storage bug that many people were having. So if we go into general and then we go down to iPhone storage, you'll see that I'm only using 69.5 gigabytes of 256 gigabytes. Before, I was using almost all of my storage under other. Apple has fixed this, and it seems like other people are reporting the same thing as well. So most people are seeing this storage bug fix. So that's great. We've got our storage back. It wasn't really affecting the overall performance or anything of my phone, but it's nice that they fixed it. Now, according to Apple's notes, there's over 40 known issues. And one of those issues is that 3D Touch is temporarily unavailable in iOS 14 Beta 3. Now, you would have to have a 3D Touch device, but you can still do haptic touch. So I'm not sure what they mean by it's unavailable. It basically feels the same. And I'm not sure, maybe they disabled the pressure layer in things like the iPhone 6S Plus, for example. But in general, it seems like you can tap and hold and it's not a problem. It's just disabled in this particular build. However, they've resolved 30 issues, including things such as accessibility with Siri when you say hey in front of it, as well as guided access now works in accessibility. And also, this is a bug, although it seems like it's just a design change, where in iMessage, app icons are now hidden when switching to the emoji keyboard. So if I go into messages, and if I go to create a new message, on the left, you'll see here is iOS 14 Beta 2 running on my iPhone XR, and then I have iOS 14 Beta 3 on the right running on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And so if I tap on the emoji keyboard here, you'll see that at the top on the left, we still have all our different icons, where now they're gone on the newer beta. So it kind of cleans up the screen, gets rid of the clutter, and then we can search emoji easily now instead of having that in the way. Now, also in messages, they've updated the Memoji as well. And now I'm not really seeing this, but it actually has to do with face covering. So if we go back and we go to our Memoji here, some people were saying the face covering has changed. I haven't seen the difference between beta 2 and beta 3, but instead of having it horizontal, they were saying there was a vertical line down the center in the older versions. I'm not seeing that, but as you can see, they look the same on my devices. So I'm not sure what people are seeing that, but some are. Now you can see there's a big change with the music icon. They've gone back to the iOS 7 style icon where it's more of a pinkish red color with a white music note in it. So if we open up the music icon or the music app and go to listen now, it's kind of the same, but they have made a few changes. So for example, when we go into library, there's now icons. So if I do the same on the previous version with iPhone XR, you'll see here on the left, there's no icons, but on the right with beta 3, we have icons now for playlists, artists, albums, songs, and downloads. Also, I noticed when you tap on an album, the buttons are a slightly different color. So on the beta 2 version, you've got play and shuffle being a red button with sort of a white play word in the middle and shuffle. But on the beta 3 version, we have play that's gray with the pinkish red color saying play. So it's a little bit different based on which version you're on. It's a nice little change. I'm not sure which one I like more, but they have updated it, and those are the changes in this particular version. Now, along with the music icon change, they've also added a new music widget. So you'll see here's the widget. It's red in color, or reddish pinkish color, with the album art inside of it. And then also we have a new clock widget. So you can see the different world clocks here. So those are newly added. And let's press and hold, and I'll show you the different styles. And it seems to be more responsive as far as the widgets are concerned. So for example, here's the clock widget, and here's the different styles and different sizes. And then if we go back, we'll go down to the music widget here, and there's the different styles and sizes as well. So you have those different music widget options if you want to use them. And of course, you can just drag them to your home screen if you want to use them. Now, initially, I did have an issue with the weather widget. It was actually black to begin with and wouldn't work. I had to delete the widget and then recreate it, and it worked properly. So that's something that they've updated. It's really nice, but when it comes to older widgets, so you'll see down here, I have my Tesla widget, as well as the current weather conditions. If I press and hold on widgets, we'll keep holding, you'll see that it's sort of separated the Tesla and weather widget into sort of a older style widget. Now, this will probably be updated once iOS 14 is available to the public in September or October, but you'll see you can customize it here and you can add these, but you can't really do anything to them. So for example, if we go to, let's say LifeX, which is some lights that I use. Now they're down here in the bottom in the widget. You can't really move this around though. You can add to it. So it's nice that they've added that, and it's just a way to use your old legacy widgets at this point until they're updated. Now, the first time you go to the widgets page, you'll actually get some more information. So I haven't gone to it on this iPhone SE. We'll slide over and you'll see it says refreshed widget. Press and hold a widget to reorganize them. In jiggle mode, tap the plus in the top left to add a widget or to add widget. And you can see they've actually called it jiggle mode now. And there's a photo of myself here, but it's a nice little update. And then if we slide over to the app library, you'll also get one the first time you go into the app library. I took a screenshot of this, so let's go into photos. And the first time you open it, it says, welcome to app library, a new home for your apps organized in smart categories. And then finally, if you press and hold on an icon, maybe you want to delete it, press and hold, you'll also get one that says edit home screens, hide unorganized home screen pages by tapping the page dots. So it just tells you, you can sort of tap the page dots, hide the home screens. It's giving a little tutorial for those who have not used it. So it's nice to see that. This will be really helpful when iOS 14 launches later this year. Now, if you're running the watchOS 7 betas, like I am on my Series 4 Apple Watch, Apple has added an additional feature to hand washing. So if we go into the Apple Watch app on our iPhone, open the app, scroll down to where it says hand washing, and under hand washing, there's a new hand washing reminder. And it says, receive a notification if you haven't washed your hands within a few minutes of returning home. So if you turn that on or off, it reboots your watch and you now can have a reminder as you return home, hey, you need to wash your hands. So it's a nice little reminder if you need that. Now, one thing that they've actually fixed that's really nice if you use Mail, or I guess they've updated to bring back what it was like in iOS 13.6. If we go into Mail, now if we tap edit, we can just use one finger, drag down and select and highlight emails. This was taken away in the previous betas. You had to use two fingers. They've brought it back how it was before. I think this is a better way to do it, and I'm glad to see they've brought this back. Now, something they've updated with the feedback app is a nice new summer newsletter. So if you go into your inbox, yesterday they actually added this. No one really caught it, but you'll see it says Summer Newsletter 1, and it explains everything in the coming weeks, what exactly is system diagnostics logs, and gives you a little bit more information about what submitting feedback does and how it works. So it's nice to see. Look out for maybe Summer Newsletter 2 in a couple weeks, but it's nice to see Apple add this so it explains more of what they're doing for different versions, such as iPadOS and watchOS 7 and all of those as well. Now, one small change I noticed is the page dots at the bottom that represent the different pages, they've actually been moved down ever so slightly on beta 3. So iOS 14 beta 3, they've moved them down just a little bit compared to beta 2 that I have here on the left. So maybe that's to make more room for widgets or resizing later on, but it's nice that they've moved them down. Also, those emoji that Apple showed off not too long ago that are coming to iOS later this fall are not yet in beta 3, or at least I couldn't find them. So that would be things like an anatomical heart and some other things as well. So there's a bunch of other emoji that comply with the Unicode consortium that other people follow as well, such as Microsoft and Android or Google with Android. Those will come to all of those devices, so they keep up to date with all the latest emoji. Now with iPadOS, well, those changes that I've talked about already are present here. However, on iPadOS, they've gotten rid of the weather widget and you can't add it. So if we go into our widgets here, press and hold, We'll add a widget. You'll see at the bottom, there's no weather widget to be found. So they've removed that, unfortunately. I would love to see them bring that back, but right now there's no weather widget on iPadOS 14. But with iPadOS, there's not really anything new. However, it's been fairly stable compared to the others. Now with iOS 14 Beta 3, it's really hard to tell how battery is without using it for a few days. So I'll be doing a follow-up on Sunday, but let's take a look at the battery life on Beta 2 that I've been using for the past couple of weeks. Now, if we go into battery, go to battery health, you'll see I'm at 96%. This is completely within spec and normal. Battery health does not go down when you update your device. It simply remeasures the physical condition of the battery. So it's completely within spec. 80% after 2 years is normal. Now, battery life for me on beta 2 was not great. You'll see here's a day I used over 75% of my battery, and I only had 4 hours and 59 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 7 minutes of screen off time. It will vary from day to day, but normally 10 to 12 hours on an 11 Pro Max is normal, and battery life on early betas is not great anyway. So it's not a big concern to me, but it may be for some people. So if battery is a concern, I would stay away from betas. And when it's closer to the final release, then that's more of a priority. Now, the overall performance has been really good. I've noticed things are much quicker as far as pressing and holding icons to bring up different menus or going into jiggle mode, for example. It just feels more responsive. Different apps, moving widgets around, things like that seem to be a little bit better. So we'll move this around. You'll see it's very responsive. Things seem much better that way. Of course, again, it will take a few days to know for sure. Now, even on older devices, it seems to be pretty fast. I would say this is faster or more responsive than iOS 14 beta 1 or 2. So again, pressing and holding icons, menus pop up quickly. If we go over to Minecraft, for example, let it load. We'll see what the frame rate is like. So just moving along like this, it does seem fairly smooth if I want to look around fast. Of course, this looks kind of ridiculous in my hands, but you get the idea here. Let's move around so I don't have to jump. It's hard for me to hit these buttons on such a small display, but you'll see it's nice and smooth. I haven't seen any choppiness or anything like that. So expect performance to be pretty good. Now let's take a look at the benchmarks and see what we've got. Now I'm using Geekbench 5. So if you want to compare your scores with what I have here, that's probably what you'll want to use. And you'll see my single core score on the 11 Pro Max is 1,338 and 3,426 for multi-core. This is better than before, and it goes along with it feeling more responsive. So you can see the different scores here. It is definitely a little bit higher with multi-core. So I would expect it to be a little bit snappier the way it feels. Just in general, it seems to be zipping along. Now, again, this could slow down a little bit over time since it is an early beta, but in general, it feels pretty good. That's it for iOS 14 beta 3. Now, if you've found anything else significant, let me know in the comments below. And if there's a bunch of changes, I'll do another video with all of the other features I've found as well. Now, expect iOS 14 beta 4, maybe on a weekly cycle at this point. That's what they've done before in the past with iOS 13, but you never know what Apple's going to do. So we'll have to wait and see as far as that goes. We may see another iOS 13 before the launch of 14, but again, it's hard to say at this point. Apple seems to be changing things up a little bit. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.